All right. Sit up nice and tall. Is everyone, it looks like everyone's sitting for the exercises. Does anyone want to toss in some legs? Or are we just wanting to focus on arms and core? Back. Leg options at all for anyone? Thumbs up? No? Maybe? All right, I'll toss out some options throughout class on what maybe you can do to add in some legs. But sit up nice and tall wherever you're at. Maybe give yourself a few little wiggles.
On a summer evening, and it sounds like a song.
I'm getting that music. Anyone else getting music?
Well,
is it loud enough for people? Can you still hear me talk?
Breathe me in.
Cool. Give yourself some shoulder rolls.
I don't know if I could ever go without.
And then hands out front, curl forward, and arch like you're doing cat-cow here from the side. So give yourself a nice big arch. Exhale. Inhale. Get that head in line with the spine. Let it flow. You can have your hands on your knees to help pull yourself through. Inhale forward. You're on the ball. Let your hips roll. You can also add in arms. Open up big. Exhale. Inhale. Curl. One more. Exhale. Inhale, come back up, drop those shoulders down away from your ears. Reach it forward. Just as far as you can, getting a little extra stretch in, torsos twist. Out to the side. Cross your body. We'll pick up the tempo in a second. Just kind of stretching out all those kinks from work and from our days. So going nice and slow, getting in that nice long stretch. Good, come back down. Sit up nice and tall. Your belly should be fired up. Ground your feet or pelvis to the chair and to the ground. From there, throw some strength up through your pelvis. So you're in a nice neutral spine at your low back. If you need help keeping your knees apart, toss a yoga block or pillow there. Sit up extra tall, inch that spine up longer. Low abs kind of suck in and up to support. Shoulders drop down away from your ears and then roll open. Squeeze those shoulder blades slightly back. Then chin tucked straight back. So if anyone hasn't done this one with us before, necks up tall, you're just pulling that, squeezing the back of your neck to pull your chin straight back, giving yourself some nice double chins here. Squeeze, and then release. If you want extra resistance, you can put your hands behind your head. You can always do this into your pillow when you're in bed, and then just push straight back. Gentle on the neck, though, so you don't want to overdo it. Release. Hands drop down. Push those shoulders down to the ground. Even more. Tuck the chin. Pull it back. Squeeze those shoulders down. Come halfway up. And then push them back down. Shoulder depressions here. Squeeze those shoulder blades down and back. Up. Down. Even more. Fire up all the way down to those fingertips.
Always make the same mistakes, yeah. Always make
shoulders all the way up to the ears this time. Shoulder shrug. And then squeeze them down and back. Depress those shoulders all the way down. Little pulses here. Squeeze lower. Nice and low in your back. Shoulder blades come together. You've got nice strong posture. Shoulders down. Thumbs are up to the ceiling. Arms down by your side. Fire it up. Come up into Ys. Super active here through your arms. Nice control, everybody. Arms stay as straight as you can. If that bothers your shoulder at all, you can always bend your elbow and let that come up. Good. Hold here halfway. Pretend like you've got like a big rubber band and a ball between your hands. Squeeze that ball. Little pulses. Hold and center. Now you've got a rubber bands on your arms. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Super active through those arms. Pulse, pulse. Good. Pause here. Little circles backwards. Open up those arms wider. Belly should still be fired up. Work those arms down. Good. From here, you can release. Shoulders down your back. Belly is up and in. You're going to hinge forward. And then we're going to lift those arms up in that Y. We're going to fly for super fans. Neck stays in line with your shoulders. So front view, up and holding. Back is flat. Shoulder blades slide down your back and squeeze. Release. I'm going to do a side view for this next one. So for the side view, I'm going to hinge forward. You can come pretty far forward. Shoulders down, up. Neck is in line with the spine. Shoulder blades squeeze down low. Back stays flat. Hold. Try to kiss those shoulder blades together at the tips. Slowly back down. Release. One more, here you go, shoulder blades down. Fire up those abs, hinge forward. Let's fly up. Squeeze those shoulder blades down. Pulse, squeeze them together even more. And then release. Come back up. Grab those resistance bands or light weights. Let's toss in some cardio with weight. You can do this with just your arm weight too. No weights and resistance bands needed. Here we go. You got weights, weights in your hands. Drop those shoulders down, fire up those abs. Reach forward. Punches here. Come back up to start. Breathe. Stabs through that low back. Good. Cross through. Breathe. Reach up. Keep it going. Forward. Keep breathing. Cross through. You got 5 more seconds here. 3, 2, 1. Good. Release that band down. Band goes underneath your feet for rows. You can also just hold the band out in front of you and do a row here. Your choice. So band underneath feet or out in front of you. Fire up those abs. Belly sucks in. Shoulders down and back. And then pull. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Shoulder blades should drive this motion. If you're, keep it going. If you're out in front, hands start together and then bring them out wide. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Hands stay chest level in front of you. If you're rowing here, hands end right at your chest, right underneath your armpits. Last 3, 2. One, release. Band stays there. Little burst of cardio here. With bands or without jumping jack arms. If you want to add the legs, get those going out, maybe one at a time. Stay centered the whole time. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Jacks. You can jump out 2 at a time. Try not to let your torso move from side to side. Stay centered. Super active through those arms. Keep it going. Good. Take it across. If you're stepping, step backwards. Slight angle back behind you. Arms alternate each time. You can go as slow or as fast as you want, as long as you're staying in control. Squeeze and squeeze back, squeeze together. Back to jumping jacks. Breathe. And arm jacks here and up. A little bit lower on those arms. Last three, two, one. Nice. Shake it out. Yeah, another round of rows. So that was a minute of jacks, three different styles. Back to rows. This time, stretch it out a little bit further. Change your angle a little bit. So either toes walk out or you hold the bands up a little higher. Here we go. Ready? Three, two, one. Go. Squeeze. Nice and controlled. Maybe slow it down. Two up, two down. Up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. Neck stays in line with that spine. Squeeze those shoulder blades. Probably just change there because we killed your momentum. Makes it a little harder. Last three, two, last one, hold it there. Hold back. See if you can't squeeze a little bit more. Maybe a little more, maybe you're there, but hold for three. Two, slowly inch it down. Nice and controlled. Nice, that messed up anyone's flow once you like started slowing that down a little bit. Make it a little harder. All right, drop those shoulders, sit up tall. So next, add in knees if you want. We're gonna go opposite elbows, opposite knee with a little crunch, staying on one side. If you want, you can add a weight to your hand. You can always add both arms at the same time to hold on to that weight if you want a little extra something. Add just the weight, or sorry, just arms, just leg, or do both. But sit up nice and tall, fire it up. We're gonna start over on your right, weights and hands on your right to left leg. Squeeze. Squeeze. You're just doing the upper body twist at an angle, twist down towards that knee. As long as that feels good on your back. Making sure you're moving from your core, not just your arms. So your hands should stay in the same space the whole time. They shouldn't move. Three, two, yes, one, switch sides. Come back center, other way. So wherever you put your arms, they stay there the whole time. You're twisting from your core over. Here we go. Squeeze. You're sitting on the ball. See if you can do it, not make the ball move. Same thing with the chairs. Try to be so still that you're not shaking through your pelvis at all. You're firing it up and squeezing. Arms stay put. And twist. Twist. Squeeze. Nice. Keep it going. You got three, two, one. Awesome. Shake that out. Arms come down. bicep curls here. So weights or bands. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Super active. Shoulders should be down. Belly should be fired up. Supporting that low back. Just supporting your back through your exercises is going to make a huge difference in the strength and endurance of your low back. Do a few more. Nice. 3, 2, 1. Arms come down, shoulders down, weights either side. Drop those shoulders down like we started. Depression's here. So you're coming up halfway with your shoulders up towards your ears and then pushing them down to the ground as much as possible. Up and down. If your arms are really close to the ground, same thing, just keep your elbows bent. Push down, maybe not with weights. Breathe. 2, 1. Hold those shoulders down. Bicep curl, hammer curl in. So thumbs come up towards your shoulders. And then you're going to push up. So into a shoulder press. Down. Bicep curl. Shoulder press. Breathe. You can do this one arm at a time, too, if it's easier for your balance. Feels better on your shoulders. Keep those wrists strong and straight. 3. Last 2. Last 1. Nice. Drop those shoulders down. Next round, ready for your cardio burst. Some of you know this one. We're gonna do the ropes out in front of us. The battle ropes. Grab a resistance band if you want to. Resistance, put it underneath your toes. You can use weights, just be careful on your shoulders. Either way, you're gonna engage that core, hinge forward a little bit, squeeze those glutes and low ab, so you're not gonna move anything from your armpits down. Everything is gonna fire up, squeeze, hold it there, arms are out in front of you. You're only gonna move your arms up and down like you're swinging a rope and trying to get it to do little waves, okay? Here we go. Bands are gonna make it a lot harder. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. Up and down, fire it up. Everything else should stay steady. Squeeze, don't let anything move. Neck in line with your spine, awesome. Breathe. Last 3, 2, 1. Come back to center. Nice. How'd that feel? All right. A little different if you don't move anything else. Here we go. Triceps are next. So find your favorite tricep exercise. You can do it up overhead. You can hinge forward and do kickbacks. Or if that's troublesome on your shoulder, you're gonna hold the band in front of you and bend and straighten your elbow out in front. So find what's good for you. Either way, nothing else moves except for your elbow. Core, back, everything stays put. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Reach. Keep breathing. Keep those elbows fired up. Shoulders stay still. 3, 2, 1. Release. We're going to do 2 sets. So we're gonna stay on the same arm if it's got it in it. And give it another 3 seconds. Get in position. 2, 1. Tries. Same arm. It's probably a little bit more fatigued. Keep it going. Neck should stay in line with your spine. Core fired up. No arching your backs here. Nice, looking strong. You got 5, 4, 3. Keep breathing. Keep it smooth. 2, 1. Whew, nice job. And then switch sides. If you ever start to lose your form, make sure you take a break, reset, instead of pushing through. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Awesome. Keep it going. Get in 5, 4. Last 2, 1. Nice. You got a 10-second rest here. And then we're going to do that side again. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Make sure that core and shoulders are still. Just your elbow bends and straightens. It starts to get harder once it starts burning a little. Make sure you're staying out of the pain zone though. 3, 2, 1. Release. Nice. Band goes underneath your feet for this if you want, or it can stay out in front of you. We're gonna get in around a reverse fly. So what it looks like without weight, I'm gonna hinge forward. My hands are just out in front of me, and then I'm gonna squeeze my shoulders back. My hands are in each other, hinged forward, squeezing back. Working that mid back. So you can keep your band here and fly, or band underneath your toes and fly out there. Just making sure you're not popping at the end. Stay nice and smooth and controlled. Lighter weight than you think. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Fly. Squeeze those shoulder blades. If you're using dumbbells, it would be here. My back is nice and flat, fired up, neck in line with my spine. 3, 2, 1. Good. So you're aiming right here in the middle of your back, in between your shoulder blades, for this one. Squeezing those together in one big unit. Got one more set. So fire up those abs, squeeze everything in, hinge forward. Legs should be stable, core stable, neck in line and squeeze. Keep it going. Breathe. Keep it smooth. Count of 2, up, down. Up, down, down. Hold this next one up. Hold it out. 3, 2, 1. Slowly back down. Weights to the side. Nice work, everyone. I'm going to start class, or end class before you started. So shoulders down by your ears, or away from your ears. Hands down by your side. Fire up those abs. Active, active. So reaching down towards the ground first. Out and about, trying to like reach for the computer the whole time through this motion. So you're firing up shoulders to fingertips, palms down, T's out to the side. A little active stretch here. Good, bring it across your body, give yourself a little stretch nice and slow. Reach it up overhead. Pause where you need to give yourself a little extra stretch. We'll have everyone pause to one side and reach a little further. Maybe even roll open that chest a little bit more, shoulders to the back wall. Come back down, reach up, over. Good, roll those shoulders. Arms out in front of you. Finger extension exercises here. So you're gonna pull those wrists back as far as you can. Fire up, so this is just halfway. This is my hands fired up. So fire up those hands, fingers. Stretch them open, squeeze them wide. Squeeze them together. You can do one arm at a time. Keep those elbows straight as you can. Half claws. Pause here. See if you can take those hands, palms super flat, down, and then squeeze them back up. Down and up, nice and controlled. A little harder than it looks. Back up, this time little tiny thumb rolls towards you. Kind of stretching those wrists out. Good, if you start to feel a burn, you can stop. Hold those hands straight, fingers stretch wide, stretch them out. Thumb to pinky, squeeze. Stretch wide, pull those wrists back. Neck should still be in your nice chin tuck, straight posture. Middle, squeeze. Little isolation, little opposition, back down. Super active. Stretch super wide, pull those fingers back and shake it out. Nice work.